To sum it up, I would say the education system is flawed completely. You're either in a mainstream environment with 30, 32 children in a class, all have very different needs. So whether you're diagnosed with a form of learning difficulty, such as dyslexia, or you just learn in a slightly different way, school isn't for you. Like, it really tries to work to the majority, but actually the majority are different anyway.
My time at state school was horrendous. I was told by the teachers, literally on one or two occasions, that I was thick. My grades proved that I was thick, because when you're at school, you're valued by your grades, and my grades were the lowest grades in the class most of the time. And that proved that I was the bottom of the class. It proved that I was thick.
Yeah, I have a really weird relationship with education. Really weird, because I'm naturally a curious person. I'm naturally somebody that wants to understand how things work and understand history and understand kind of the process of ideas. But yet schooling I found really, really difficult. And, you know, especially as a young kid, you know, being put in the huts is like, I'd come home in tears every day, because, you know, you've got this conflict between, I'm pretty sure I'm a curious kid and I'm not naughty, but yet for some reason, and looking at my early works, you know, you'd get a paragraph or a few paragraphs of work where every other word was spelt incorrectly. You know, it was absolutely being hammered into me constantly that I couldn't do this, that it wasn't right. And for a long time, that sort of stayed with me.
I didn't have a positive educational experience, if I'm honest. Now I know it's because I had dyslexia. I was always quite described as quite a bright child, if you like. And then when I moved to secondary school, I slipped down sets. And that was really hard, because I didn't understand why that was happening, because I was kind of excelling the same amount of effort as I'd always done. And I just didn't understand why I wasn't getting it and why my effort wasn't equaling my attainment.
Because I have a working memory problem, when I would have to copy large amounts of text from a board or something like that, or I had to take a lot of notes quite quickly in a lecture at university, for instance, I'd find that very difficult, because I would be able to write the notes, but I wouldn't be able to concentrate on what is happening at the same time. I sort of have to pick one. Either I can take notes in a meeting or I can pay attention. And so when I was at school, it really depended on the teacher's style. So if something was more visual or more practical, I would engage more. But if there was sort of more writ and there was more focused on, writing things down from a blackboard, I found that very difficult.
I couldn't understand. This is the thing. They give you tasks to do. And I remember not understanding them. But I also remember not understanding why I didn't understand them. That was one of the things. And again, that's kind of maybe my executive function, that I didn't know what it was at the time, but I just didn't understand why I didn't understand what everyone else had to do. Interestingly, one of my best subjects, the one that I wasn't the bottom of the class at, was English. I never read anything. We had to read like Far From the Madding Crowd and Hard Times and stuff like that, and I never read them. But I'd talk to people about what they were about, and I could understand them better than they could. They'd read them, but I could understand them just from hearing what they were about and reading a couple of snippets. So I was rescued by my English, strangely enough. But time at school was rough, if I'm honest.
What really changed in education after a while was learning that actually if I learned in a special way or in a way that worked for me, that actually I could really do it. And not only that, I could excel at it. But for me, learning was not about being parrot fashioned, you know, from a teacher in front of me that was just giving me information. That was never going to work. You know, like, it would just be, my mind would be all over the place, you know, and I'd be wanting to think about other things. I need to be involved in the debate. You know, if you want to talk to me about how that camera's working or whatever, you know, there's no point telling me, like, we're going to have to talk about it. I'm going to have to be able to ask questions. We're going to have to be able to investigate it. And I'm probably going to need to understand it to the point where I can teach it back to you, rather than just that way. And maybe we're going to have to assess me in a slightly different way, because if you ask me to write things down, I don't know, that's going to be tricky for me, because I'll miss out things, I'll miss out nuances. And so maybe we have to do the assessment in a slightly different way about talking about what you've shown me. And I think what really came to light, that came to light much more in my master's, where I had a bit, being honest, had a bit more money, so I could get more sort of private tuition as well, where I could have those debates.
From my children's perspective, their education has been positive because I felt like I could advocate for them. I've known what dyslexia is, I've known what they've needed to be successful. And I think I don't view it as a barrier. I view it as something, it's part of them, it's something they've got, and we just need to negotiate and find our way around it. So it's not that I haven't got high expectations where education and academia is concerned, but I think it's about playing to my children's strengths, and they're not necessarily academic. They're really good at music, they're really good at the creative arts and performing. And I've just really made sure that we kind of balance out those educational experiences with positive experiences outside of school.
I think it's just because I felt I was just a bit different in a way, like, and I think I was getting so frustrated with myself because I was never achieving the maximum, like, potential that I know I have. And I think it was quite frustrating for me, like, doing, like, little things like spelling tests when you were younger. I always felt like I was never, like, good. And I was like, what do you mean? I've tried so hard for this. Why am I not getting, like, the same as my friends, you know? And I think that was the most frustrating thing, always feeling like I'm never, like, good enough for, like, everyone around me. But, and then I obviously went into secondary school in year seven, and then everything kind of went back to normal, but it didn't really feel like normal. It was still weird. And then me going, like, wanting to go home again, it's always, like, came back, you know. I just wanted to go home. I was in the office like every other day. I just really didn't like it for some reason. I think that was so hard. And then year eight, friendships hit. And then I ended up getting bullied by a group of girls who I didn't like. And I think that was the hardest thing. So, and then on top of schoolwork, it just, I couldn't bear it. And I think the schoolwork was getting so much, I used to have so much anxiety about not doing the homework right or not getting it in on time. There was so much to worry about, and so, like, so many tests, so many books to read, so many poems to remember. There was so much. I think it just became so overwhelming that I ended up leaving school 2 weeks into year nine. We started homeschooling, online school, till we could find me, like, a replacement school that was gonna help me.
So they would teach in a way that I just wouldn't get. If they repeated it and, like, helped me, I just still wouldn't get it. But at my new school, because everybody's dyslexic, like, it makes more sense. And, like, even if I don't understand it from the teacher, if I'm sitting next to my friend, he will explain it to me and it'll just make sense because we work the same in some ways. So I'd say teaching at my new school is good because, well, it's just how they teach. I don't know how to describe it, but how they do it is just great.
In his previous school, he did get an enormous amount of help. The SENCO, the Special Educational Needs Coordinator, was amazing. But despite all the extra help, Jack was falling further and further and further behind, to the point where we noticed as parents that it was beginning to impact his self-confidence, you know, always being, you know, not being able to complete his homework, struggling at school.
We loved her first school. If you really knew me, you'd find this a very strange thing for me to say, but we loved the headmaster at our old school.
Which one?
The first one.
Oh, yeah, he was.
And Lily did too. And it was just a very strange thing for me to talk about school and. I just wanted to play football when I was at school, yeah. But the education side really come home, and that headmaster was really focused on not just maths and English, but the creative side. And you could see that she really enjoyed her schoolwork. The headmaster changed to a headmistress who had a different focus, and it was all maths and English because it was all about making sure that the school's SATs, or I'm not even sure if they were SATs then, but their academic grading was more focused on that. And that really did hinder Lily. And that's when it really came into focus.
When I look back to my time in a state school, you just think, oh my goodness, the amount of students who would have been struggling, but they mask it so well. They're great students at masking. and everything will be all right. And they say they're fine because they want to go under the radar. They want to not be noticed because they don't want that attention. They don't want the teacher to go, right, you know, and then everyone looks around at them. Then they're targeted. Then the whole kind of cycle starts. So extremely hard state school. I'm sure there's some great state schools out there that do provide that. But a lot of the time they have their separate units. So it's almost like you're being, I don't know what the right word is, not targeted, but you're being labelled, because they'd be like, right, go to the special unit, and then all your mates are like, oh, what's wrong with you? And then you get targeted, labelled straight away, whereas in a special setting, everyone is the same, everyone is comfortable. I know you've spoken to students at our school, and they just feel everything's natural. Yeah, they're all the same, they don't need to stand out, you know, so they can be comfortable and express themselves how they are.
I am generally just passionate about education and most importantly that every single child is entitled to an education and an education that suits them and that fits what they need to achieve. So for me, it's not just about kids with SEN, it's about your really high achievers, it's about your kids that are just middle of the road and often forgotten about because of the quiet ones and they just got on with their work. Every single child needs to have that support.
It felt like a family almost. It was so weird. It was just, when I went there, I was like, this is a school? I was like, it's so weird. It feels like, it's like a school, but it's so different and it's so unique. And I think, like, that's the thing. It was just like, it came from me hating school to now my attendance is like so much better. I go in all the time. Like I never complain about going to school anymore. And I think it's so weird. Even when I started telling my family friends like, oh, I love going to school. They were like, what? You know, you're joking, like you're lying. I was like, everyone was so shocked because everyone knew me as, oh, Ruby's always faking ill. She's always sick. Like, you know, wasn't it? So I think, yeah, it's so weird, and it just shows if you're in the right environment, it can change completely who you are.
At Moon Hall, Jack did a taste today. It's probably quite a good example. He did a taste today, and he went there for the first day, and he came home, and he said, it is so great. They're all like me, and I feel as if I fit in. And that was the taste today, and it's stayed like that.
Now, coming to special education, school like Moon Hall, I just think she's come on leaps and bounds. Her confidence. The transition from one school to another was quite difficult, but that was purely the social side, leaving her friends, going on to a new school, at a time as well when, you know, if your friends are everything. And it did take a little while for her to adjust, but now, God, I don't think you drag her out of there.